Welcome back to my channel, or if this is your first time visiting my channel, then welcome. My name is Jillian, and today I have a Dollar Tree fall haul. I also have a few Halloween items in here, and I think three or four things that are not fall or Halloween related that I still am going to share with you guys because I did purchase on the same day. Also, since this is a Halloween fall haul, I figured I would pull out my Hocus Pocus shirt. I am a huge Hocus Pocus fan, and every year I always watch it, and I've been waiting to pull this shirt out, and I figured I would wear it today because I still have not worn it out because people will probably still look at me like I'm crazy if I wear this out already, but I took advantage and I'm wearing it in this video. Also, a really quick disclaimer, you guys are probably gonna hear my kids in the background. It is the weekend, so they are home. So if you guys hear them in the background, I do apologize about that. I know a few people hate when I film with my kids home because they say it's a distraction when they hear my kids in the background, but you know what? I'm a mom, life isn't perfect, and sometimes I can't film when they aren't home and I have to film when they are home from school. So if you guys don't like to hear kids in the background, then this video might not be for you. But anyways, we're gonna jump in to this haul really quickly. So the first few things are gonna be larger items, which is this wreath form. So I am hosting a girls' night at my house. At the end of September, we're gonna be making fall wreaths, and I found this pumpkin one. I've never found this at Dollar Tree before. I always see just like the regular circle ones. So I got super excited. I don't know how I'm gonna make this wreath. I've never done a wreath like this, but I'm really excited. So I picked that up. And then for the outside of my house, I picked up this, which I had last year, but obviously I threw it out because it got damaged from being outside for like 2 months. But it just says, "Welcome to our patch." And I'll probably do the same thing I did last year, putting it in our porch with like some hay and stuff and a pumpkin. So I bought that one. And then I bought one for Halloween, which says Wicked. And then it has a broom and also like a witch hat on top. So I'll probably be putting this outside for Halloween as well. So I'm gonna show you guys all the fall items first, and then I will share with you guys the Halloween one. So first fall item is this for my wreath. I don't know how exactly I made my wreath, but I bought these clip-on maple leaves and they are orange with glitter. I still need to pick up a lot more for my wreath, but I still have some fall little craft stuff. So I don't know, I'll have to go through and see what I need, but I picked up this for that wreath. Next item is this little wooden sign that says thankful. I thought that was so pretty. I loved the colors. They do have another one. It might say grateful. I'm not completely sure, but they do have another one that I'm thinking about going back for and then doing like a little DIY where I glue them together and stack them. I'm not sure, but this is the one that I picked up. The other few signs I picked up was this one that says happy harvest, and then it has a pumpkin with a cute little bow right there. And then I found these that I thought were really cute. So I got one in cream and one in orange. This one says gather with grateful hearts. The lettering is in gold. And then this one's orange. And this one says pumpkin kisses and harvest wishes. And that is in white. So I just figured these were really cute and it would be a great addition to my house for fall. So I grabbed those two. So the last few items from fall items is all pumpkins. And this year I'm gonna be decorating my bathrooms and my office area just because I know I'm gonna have a huge pile of pumpkins and I'm not gonna have anywhere to put them. So definitely gonna be decorating areas of my house that I usually don't decorate. But I got these two. This one is a cream color with the gold little stem, and then this one's orange with the gold stem as well. And I'm telling you guys, if you guys shop at Target's Dollar Spot, last year they had pumpkins that looked exactly like these. I'm pretty sure they are identical. Maybe the size is different, but I'm pretty sure they look almost the same. Once I pull those down from the attic, I'm gonna compare them because they seriously look exactly the same. So I bought those two, and then I found these I thought were so pretty. I feel like you guys can find this like at Hobby Lobby or Home Goods, stuff like that. That'll be much more than a dollar. So I got this one that was orange, and then I got this one that's like a creamy beige color, and I just thought these were beautiful. So I grabbed these two, and then I grabbed four of these velvet pumpkins. So I grabbed two of like the off-white cream color. And what I think I'm gonna do, I don't really like the stem part, so I think I'm gonna DIY that and either paint it or put like glitter on it. I'm not sure, but I'll probably change the stems. But I got two of the cream white ones, and then I got like this champagne colored one, and then just like the traditional orange color. So I did grab four. Like I said, I will most likely change out the stems just because I'm not too crazy about them. They are plastic, so it kind of looks cheap with that stem. So I don't know, I might paint or cover it with glitter so it can look a little more prettier. Now I'm gonna show you guys the Halloween items that I got. I only got a few. So this year I am also going to be hosting a Halloween party, so I figured the little table setup that I plan on doing, these will be really cute items to put on that table. So I got this that says Trick or Treat, and it's a little house, and then you can have it light up. So I bought that one, and then I bought this one that just says Happy Halloween with a little bat, and the same thing, it does light up. So I thought that would be really cute on a table. And then also to put on a table, I thought would be really cute is this skeleton. I think it's meant to put like a little small candle up there. I'm not sure if I'll put a candle there. Maybe I will. I don't know. Maybe I'll grab another one and then buy like the long candles and put them in there, put it on the table. I'm not sure, but I just thought that was really cute. And then the last Halloween item I bought was this. It says, "Beware, the Wicked Witch and her little monsters live here." I thought that was really cute. You know, I am a mom of two, so I thought that would be perfect to put in our house. I decided to grab a new Halloween bucket. I think I threw out the last two that I had because they were super old. And I found this really cute one. It's just a black bucket and it's a little kitty cat. So I thought this would be a great bucket to use for when we are giving out candy to the trick-or-treaters, but also for when we have a Halloween party, I can put some snacks in here for the kids. And then the last few items has nothing to do with Halloween or fall, but I did find them and I decided to grab them. So the first thing, if you guys watched my previous Dollar Tree haul, I did haul this, but I grabbed another one. Thought this would be a really cute stocking stuffer for either my sister or my mom. They're just nail clippers and it comes with two different sizes, and they are rose gold and they're mermaids. So thought that was really cute. Then I found this that I thought would be really cute to just stash and put away and save for one of the kids' teachers. But this says, "I'm as lucky as can be with the world's best teacher teaching me." So I thought that was cute. It has a little apple on the top, so I grabbed that. Then I thought this would be a perfect like stocking stuffer for Ryan. He loves dinosaurs, and this is a little game. It's called Dino War Matching Pairs, so grabbed that. Next is this little food storage container. I've never seen these at my Dollar Tree, and this is the only one that I found. If not, I would have grabbed another one, but I thought this would be perfect to put in the kids' lunch boxes, like to pack one of their snacks. So I grabbed one of those. Then I found this cute change purse. My grandma would love this. My grandma loves little change purses like this. So I got her this, and it has like unicorns and cats and popsicles, a bunch of really cute pictures. So I grabbed her that. And the last random item I have is this magnetic list pad. So the one I currently have only has maybe like three sheets left on it. I like to use these to write down my list anytime I go shopping so I don't forget anything. So this has two magnets on the back so you can put on the side of your fridge or in the front. And it just says "Be kind" with a cute little deer. So I grabbed that. And Dollar Tree has a ton of different like little list pads that I love to get them from because it's super affordable and they last me a while. So that is the last item that I purchased from Dollar Tree. All right, guys, so that is going to end my Dollar Tree haul. I hope you guys enjoyed today's video. If you did, please remember to give it a thumbs up and also subscribe. I would love to have you be a part of my YouTube family. Also, remember to turn on your notification bell so you don't miss out on any of the fun videos I do plan on uploading soon. I will have a lot more fall-related videos coming out soon. I plan on filming a clean and decorate with me for fall, a fall house tour, a fall try-on haul. So I have a lot of fun videos planned, so definitely subscribe so you don't miss out on the fun. Thank you so much for watching today's video. I hope you guys have an amazing day, and I'll see you guys next time.